Right now, Congressman Chairman Paul Ryan from the great state of Wisconsin is here to go on the record about a new bill to fast-track free trade deals through Congress. Congressman, nice to see you. And you corrected me during the break. You said we don't call it fast-track anymore.
We call it Trade Promotion Authority.
Why do we change the name?
Well, first of all, because this promotes trade. Here's what's happening. The rest of the world is going around getting trade agreements, and U.S. is losing. There is a race right now to write the rules of the global economy. The question is, who's going to write the rules? Is it U.S. and our allies, or is it, in this case, China? And so what we're trying to do is make sure that we write the rules of the global economy that benefit American workers, that benefit American jobs. Let's remember one thing, Greta. 96% of the world's consumers, they don't live in this country. They live in other countries. And so if we want to have good-paying jobs and a faster economy, we've got to make and grow more things in America and sell them overseas. In order to do that, you have to have trade agreements that open other countries' markets to our products. Without trade agreements, companies end up building factories overseas to sell in those markets. By getting trade agreements, we actually make things in America and sell them overseas. You add up all the countries we have trade agreements with, we have a surplus with them.
Okay.
But you add up the countries we don't have trade agreements with, we have a deficit with them. So we want better trade because it means more jobs, more take-home pay for working Americans.
As I understand, there are two issues here. One is the Trans-Pacific Partnership. Mm-hmm. That's the trade deal. That's one issue. The other issue is how fast it can get through Congress, right?
Yes.
Yeah,
so
those are two issues on the table.
Right. So the TPP is an agreement.
It's the deal. That's the deal.
It isn't a deal that hasn't been reached yet. That's being negotiated. So that doesn't exist yet. The administration is negotiating with 11 other Pacific nations.
Okay, so stop it. That's what I wonder. So Congress is willing to say to the president, we're going to give you the speedy deal, the speedy press, but we don't know what your deal is.
No, not quite. So what it says is, nothing that stops a president from going and getting a trade agreement and then bringing it to Congress. We're saying Congress is going to be involved in this process at the front end. Congress is going to be in the driver's seat along with the administration on getting a trade agreements. And so we're putting 150 guidelines to the president saying, here's what a trade agreement needs to look like if you want to bring it back to Congress. And oh, by the way, we want more transparency and more accountability. For instance, once a trade agreement is reached, it has to go to the public for the public to see for 60 days before Congress considers it. So what we're saying is more accountability, more transparency, and congressionally imposed guidelines. And if the White House doesn't do that, then Congress reserves the right to remove Trade Promotion Authority at the end of the day on any particular trade agreement. And Congress has the final say-so. So what we're doing is we're asserting congressional authority here, and we're making sure, though, that we can get the best deal, because you can't have negotiations with another country if that country thinks when you bring it back to Congress, they're just going to rewrite the agreement.
So you're getting out ahead of it then, ahead of it in terms of the agreement first. Why do the unions hate it?
Well, unions have typically been against trade agreements to begin with. Here's what I would say to unions. We have to make more things in America and sell them overseas if we want good jobs. One in five jobs in America is tied to trade. And on average, those jobs pay more. So it's really important that we open up more markets. The other point I'd say is, if you're not getting trade agreements, you're losing, because other countries are going around getting trade agreements for themselves that leaves America on the outside looking in, losing. Let me give you an example. In Asia, there have been 48 trade agreements in Asia since the year 2000. The U.S. has been a party to two. And as a result, our share of trade, meaning selling goods into this area, has gone down 42%. China is going around the world right now trying to write the rules for the global economy to benefit China. So this, in many ways, is a race for us to write the rules of the global economy, to be a counterweight against China, so that trade can work for America. Because if we're not getting trade agreements that bring the world to our standards, then the standards are going to be degraded, they're going to be lowered, and we're not going to succeed.
15 seconds. Bipartisan?
Yes.
Is this one of those bipartisan where you lop off one Democrat, or is this a real bipartisan?
This is a real bipartisan. It's been bipartisan introduced in the House, bipartisan in the Senate, and it's going to be bipartisan votes. Look, I understand there's anxiety with trade, but if we want more jobs, if we want faster economic growth, if we want to be able to find markets for our products, get access to a billion customers, we already give these countries access to our markets. It's time we get access to their markets.
Congressman, nice to see you.
Thank you.
Too bad about those Badgers.
I know. Well, we got close.
Indeed. Anyway, nice to see you, sir.
You too.